Does where you live affect how long you will live? New research has revealed that people living in the north of England are 20% more likely to die prematurely than those in the south.
The study looked at 5 decades of death records to reveal a tale of two Englands, with the north and south divided by resources and life expectancy. So what are the numbers? Well, the study led by the University of Manchester found that there were 1.2 million more premature deaths in the north from 1965 to 2015, and nearly 15,000 more in 2015 alone.
There are a third more early deaths in the north amongst 25 to 34-year-olds in 2015.
And it's even bleaker for 35 to 44-year-olds. There were nearly 50% more premature deaths in the north than the south in the same year.
And if we look at some of the life expectancies, we can really see the differences. Women in the southwest are likely to live to 83.9 years, whereas those in the northeast are likely to have a life expectancy of over 2 years less.
For men in the southwest, a life expectancy of 80.2. Again, that's over 2 years more than those living in the northeast.
Well, let's get more on this now with Sky's Rebecca Williams, who's in Bath. Firmly in the south there, Rebecca. Do they feel that they're going to be living longer?
Well, that's what this report says for sure. And yeah, what a great place to tell this story than in this very iconic city in the south of England. And of course, as you mentioned there, this report, which has been put together by the University of Manchester, showing today that in the last 50 years, a million more people have died prematurely in the north of England. And you are at 20% more likely to die before the age of 75 if you live up north. Now, like I say, this research has been put together in Manchester, and the authors of this report saying it clearly shows a tale of two Englands. They are saying that governments need to do more to address the imbalance. So we are asking, is there still a north-south divide? I've managed to find someone here in Bath who's from the north. Ian, you live near Manchester.
Yeah.
What do you make of this research that perhaps people living up north could die younger?
I don't think it's accurate. Well, it probably is accurate, but I still think in some ways, if you've got good genes, you've got good genes. And if you haven't, well, that's the luck of the draw.
And do you think there is still a north-south divide?
Well, not in my head, but maybe some people have it.
And how about coming down here? You're here for the day. Where's the better place to live in terms of health?
Probably here. There's no mills.
But you'd rather live up north, would you?
No, if I had the money, I'd come down here.
You would come down. Thanks very much for your views.
Okay,
there we go. So we managed to find one person from up north. We spoke to a few more earlier, and in fact, they did say that they thought there was still a huge north-south divide. And like I say, the report authors today are blaming the government, saying they need to do more. The government has responded, though, and they say they try to do all they can to make sure that people get the most out of life wherever they live.
Rebecca, thanks very much.